Gary from mrgshave. Shave of the day, number 50. Today I'm doing safety razors or DE razor shaves or SE, whichever. So just to remind everybody, I've got to comb my beard out. Just to remind everybody, Wednesdays is straight razors, Fridays is head shaves, Saturdays is DE or SE shaving. So today is DE. Let's go to the software. Just got this delivered today, Pears Soap. I've heard good things about it. I remember these in days of old, but I don't think you can get this now in your standard sort of high street shop, or at least if you can, let me know. I had to get this off eBay. That's the pre-shave. It's glycerine soap, so it's perfectly good for a pre-shave. Wickham Soap Company, one of my Christmas presents, Irish Fern. Love the smell of this. Oh, just stunning. And I haven't even taken the wrapper out, the seal out. Wow, that's even better. That's stunning. Really love the smell of that. Sort of woodsy, pine. I've heard some people say it smells like a urinal. I don't get that. I don't think it smells that bad. But it's certainly got that pine scent that you sometimes find in you know, toilet bowl cleaner, that kind of stuff. But even so, I love the smell of that. Probably one of my favourite scents, that is. Tea Tree and Witch Hazel by Boots. That's the tonic. Then following that up with Floid Black. Lovely aftershave this. And then finishing off with Lee aftershave 3-in-1. So that should, so that's all the software. Hardware wise, Giles Shaving Co. soap bowl. Definitely my favourite soap bowl. I am going to talk about some of my favourite manufacturers. So I mean, there I've mentioned Boots for the tonic, the tea tree and witch hazel. Wickham Soap Company has been a big surprise and a great surprise to me in 2020, and is now probably one of my favourite soaps. That alongside Sterling. Sterling, superb value for money. Can't say anything bad about it, really. And then Razor Rock soaps. I've only got, I think I've only got two Razor Rock soaps, but they're good. But top of the ladder for me is definitely Wickham Soap Company for me for 2020. Giles Shaving Co. bowl, definitely my award winner for 2020, if you like. Not that there is an award. I'm using a Yaqi shaving brush. This is the Evil Zebra. Yaqi is the brand that I would say is my favourite brand for 2020 for brushes. Love Yaqi brushes. Then the razor that I'm using, this is not one of my favourites. This is one that I've done a tiny, literally minuscule amount of repair work to, because the blade wasn't quite aligning. You could only really see that the blade was out of alignment with a jeweler's loop or a microscope, but it was out of alignment, so I'm hoping that I've fixed it. But nevertheless, this is the Parker 99R. This is a razor that was given to me by one of my giveaway winners, John Peplow. And he said he found it was too aggressive. I think this is a very aggressive razor. And I'm not saying that, you know, it was a faulty razor. I just think it was the center bar in it. The bar down the center here was slightly off. And I just got a pair of pliers to it and bent it a little bit until I could get the blade absolutely perfectly straight. Now, I don't know. Let me see. I don't know whether this will focus or not yet. I'm hoping you can see the blade is now in perfect alignment. But before, it just didn't didn't sit right. So, but again, I don't think it was out enough to affect the shave. So I'm not saying John wasn't careful enough or anything. I'm saying, John, you're right. It's a very, very aggressive razor, and I would put it up there. Well, we'll see after my face shave, but certainly on the head, it was the most aggressive razor I think I'd used. Anyway, so that's what I'm using. The blade in there today, I've got an Astra Green on its second use. So I'm going to get myself ready and I'll be right back. Right, I'm back. I've just opened up the Pears Soap. There's the wrapper. Oh, I'd forgotten that smell, you know. That's an amazing smell. An amazing scent. Just trying to see. I haven't got my glasses on. Pears Transparent Soap. So I'm not sure whether that's going to be in focus. There you go. Pears Transparent Soap. So let's get some water on. I am recording, yep. And let's just rub some of this soap on the face. So this is the first time I've used Pears as a pre-shave. But as I say, it is a glycerin soap and I've heard good things about it in the shaving community, so thought I'd give it a go. I've put some soap, some soap in the bottom of the bowl. Just squeezing out the brush, a couple of shakes, and there's no water coming out of there, so that should be sufficient for now. You can always add water, you can't take it away. But as you can see, this is lathering up really nicely. And now I'm going to go in water and I'll finish up lathering and I'll be right back. Right, I'm back. Let's go for it. A bit more water. And the lather has come up really nicely. So let's go for it. Yeah, so if you haven't watched any of my previous videos this year, please go back and have a look. Thank you to all my new subscribers. I really appreciate it. It means a lot to me. But yeah, Happy New Year to everybody. Look at the lather on this. I gotta say, this Wickham soap has been amazing. So in this video, I'm gonna try and talk my way through, off the top of my head, what my standout manufacturers were of 2020. And as I said, Wickham Soap Company is definitely up there. In terms of the pre-shave, I would definitely say the Perazzo pre-shave is my go-to. The pre-shave cream from Perazzo is superb. Never fails and is excellent. The soaps, I've given you the names, so Wickham Soap Company, Sterling, superb, and Razor Rock, also really good honorary mention. The post-shave tonic, the Boots Tea Tree and Witch Hazel, excellent. Going with the grain. Let's see how aggressive this really is. Now this doesn't feel as aggressive as it did on my head. This feels quite comfortable now. That's quite nice. In terms of aftershaves, that's a difficult one because there are so many good ones. I love the CAD, Phoenix Artisan Accoutrements CAD. That's really nice. The Floid Black is really nice. But value for money, I would say the Boots Freshwood and the Superdrug version of the same. The Boots and Superdrug have brought, you know, have got some really cheap aftershave splash, eau de cologne, whatever you want to call it. I just call them all aftershaves. I would say those are the ones that I think are the best value for money, and they perform equally as well as some of the more expensive splashes that I have. So I think one's called Freshwood, and I can't remember, I'll put it up on the screen what the Superdrug one is called. It might come to me in a minute. So that's the aftershave, and then post-shave Balm is the Nivea Sensitive, but in an equal position is the Nivea, I'll show it to you, the Nivea Moisturising Cream that I sometimes use as an aftershave balm. So these are the two products that are standout for me for 2020. Love them. Can't get enough of them. I'm on my fourth tub of this stuff in 1 year. So that's the software side. This hardware side, we'll start with the razor, and I've got to say the Edwin Jagger 316 stand out the best razor for me. Loved it. Love the fit and finish of it. It's high quality. Edwin Jagger 316, followed closely by probably the Razor Rock Game Changer and the Rockwell 6C. I mean, I kind of put the adjustables in a separate bracket, but Rockwell 6C would definitely be my standout adjustable. Although I don't really, I think it sort of fits in the slot between your standard DE and your adjustable. A real adjustable is something like the Gillette Slim adjustable that I've got, the vintage one, the Merca Progress. Those you can adjust on the fly. The Rockwell 6C, you've got to take the razor apart and change plates out and things like that. And that to me isn't really adjustable. You tend to just find the plate that suits you best and then you stick with that. So, right, let's get on with the second pass. So those are the razors. I'm not going to do a straight razor because I've only just started, and right now if I had to choose, it would probably be the TASR Legrello Medal d'Or that I've just used in my first straight razor video. I have tried several other razors, but I haven't tried them enough to sort of form a real opinion, but so it's unfair to pick one in the straight razors because I'm too new to it. So I don't really want to pick a straight razor. One of the standout items in my shave den, hardware wise, this spray gun. I've seen quite a few other shavers get this now. I was turned on to the idea by MC Shaving, Mark from MC Shaving, if you're watching, thanks mate. He had like a pump one that pressurized and then you could spray it. I couldn't find that over here and it was too expensive to get one shipped from the States, so I looked for the next best thing and that was brilliant. So where are we? Brushes, I've said Yaqi. Bowl, definitely Giles & Co. Razor, Edwin Jagger 316, Razor Rock Game Changer 0.84. And then in its own category, I've got the Rockwell 6C. Love that razor as well. that's probably my top picks for 2020, if I'm honest. Right, let's go across the grain. Concentrate on what I'm doing before I forget. Second pass. There's a lot of feedback and you can definitely feel the blade. You know, it is an aggressive razor, but it's not aggressive, not as aggressive as the R41. No way. especially with this blade in it, the Astra Green. It's calmed it down. Still see the mark where I nicked myself with the straight razor. Little memory line. So, this has been a very good exercise. The Parker 99R, yes, it is an aggressive razor, but I actually find it really comfortable. I would say it's probably a touch more aggressive than the Edward & Jagger 316 and the 0.84 Game Changer. So yeah, it's definitely a level up. I would put it alongside maybe the Mule Rocker in that sort of the way it feels on the face. It was probably a mistake to use that for the first time ever on my head. That was probably a mistake because I did cut myself quite a bit on my head using the Parker 99R. It could be that because I've realigned the centre bar a little bit, that might have been the problem. I doubt it. I honestly think it is straight out of the box a very aggressive razor. But it's, you know, as I say, it's not in the same category as the Mule R41 as far as I'm concerned. I guess it depends on the blade you put in there. And the one thing I will say is that, I mean, it's the first Parker I've ever had. But the impression that I've had from other people reviewing Parker razors is that the quality control maybe needs some attention. Not every razor comes out, you know, as it should. So we're going against the grain now. So on this side it's across. But I do like the heft of this razor. It's really good weight to it. Lather falling off. It's not a bad sign, got it correctly hydrated, as long as it doesn't come off too easily. This soap, the scent, I can understand why some people would say it smells like a public toilet, you know, the cleaning chemicals they use in a public toilet, but I love this. It's to me, it doesn't smell like that at all. It smells fresh, woodsy. It's like walking through the woods, a pine forest or, you know, spruce forest, but more woodsy than that and musky. So it's not as heavy on the pine scent and spruce scent as say the Wickham Soap Company's Christmas Spruce. That was literally like walking through the forest. This has got more of a cologne in the background. So let's see how we did. Usual spots, but much of the very little to pick up. So a very good efficient shave. Definitely feels quite different to the shave I had on my head. The one I had on my head was, I would put it in the class of not a very comfortable shave. But this has been very comfortable. Has been absolutely fine. No weepers, as IMCDB says, no weepers, no creepers, no bubbles. I forget all the words he uses. But yeah, nice. I actually do think I have got a weeper there, having said that. But that's fine. You get them. you open up bumps on your face. If you have got a any kind of pimple, anything like that, then whether you're using a straight or a DE, certainly one as aggressive as this, the head is going to come off that pimple, that's for sure. This is not a razor that you want to go over the same spot too many times with, though, I will say that. That's me done. Great shave. Great shave. Very comfortable. Very enjoyable. Glad I've done it now. You know, I was dreading it a little bit because I thought, well, if it's that bad on my face, I'm going to end up, you know, with using the little Nick stick on camera a bit more than I'd want to. but yeah, that's it. I'm going to clean myself up and I'll be right back for the post-shave. I'm back. Just go with the cold rinse. Oh. Feels so nice. Do like the cold rinse. It's one of the best bits of the shave for me. Is that cold rinse at the end just wakes up the brain cells. Makes you feel alive. Right. So yeah, so in terms of manufacturers and so on, it's that's everything that I think I've covered everything there. Can't think of anything else off the top of my head. If I do, I'll mention it next week. But that's me for this week. I've got to do my post shave. There's me about to finish off, and I haven't done my post shave. So here we go. Bit of my boots, tea tree and witch hazel. Oh, that's got a bit of burn to it. I haven't done the alum. Didn't think it was necessary, but feeling that burn off the tea tree and witch hazel, maybe I did need to use the alum, but I think it's fine. On with the Floid Black. That's also burning. But that's expected. If any of the aftershave's got alcohol in it, it's going to burn. But that's nice. Love the smell. Goes very well with that Irish fern. And then Lee aftershave 3-in-1 balm. It's quite runny. But I'm using enough of my head and my face. Nice scent to this, goes well, funnily enough, with the aftershave. And that's basically shave done. So, as I say, from now on, Wednesdays, straight razor shave, Friday, head shave, Saturday, DE razor shave. So it's bye-bye from me, bye-bye from the Parker 99R. Very respectable shave, really enjoyed it this time, far more than I did on the head, so I won't be using this on my head again, but it's definitely going to stay in my den now. See you next week.